I remember sitting in my high school biology classroom when my teacher told me about evolution. They were explaining the bottleneck and founder effect. When a small group of individuals exit a population and move to a new area, only a fraction of the gene pool is taken with them. Because of this, the new population has reduced genetic diversity and are less likely to survive in their new environment. But then I thought, how can invasive species take over new environments if they go through a bottleneck? Apparently, this is a question many conservation biologists were asking as well. In many parts of the world, new introduced species have success, exponential growth, and increased diversity. These populations cause major damage to the environment and economy, with about 50,000 introduced species causing approximately $137 billion of damages per year. Like many others, Jason Kolbe and his research team wanted to know more about how introduced species can defy population genetics norms. A highly invasive lizard, the Brown Anole, provided a great opportunity for them to discover this. We begin this journey in Cuba, the native home of the Brown Anole. Kolbe took 320 lizards from 71 populations and sequenced mitochondrial and genomic DNA using PCR analysis. Through this analysis, Kolbe found a high level of variation between different native populations, but not within them. These genetic samples were run through phylogenetic computer simulations to identify geographically isolated clades within the Cuban population. A phylogenetic tree could be constructed using this simulation and allowed Kolbe to assign haplotypes to the genetic variants within Cuba. We now venture to Florida. The same sequencing procedure was completed for 199 lizards from 40 populations. The results of this analysis were vastly different to their findings in Cuba. Invasive lizards had increased in within population diversity by an average of 1.8% compared to Cuba. As they ventured north, the annals became even more diverse, continuing to defy the bottleneck effect. However, they found that these lizards had genetic sequences which blended various Cuban haplotypes. When in Cuba, population haplotypes are geographically isolated and cannot exchange genetic material. When the annals are introduced to Florida, previously isolated individuals can reproduce with others and increase genetic diversity within populations. There is still more to this story, however. Kolbe then looked at the history of introduction into Florida to find how different populations could mix. In the late 1800s, brown annals from west and west central Cuba were introduced to South Florida. This population experienced a lag phase and even had reduced diversity compared to Cuban populations. This is the bottleneck effect in action. An exponential growth in population and diversity occurred around 1940 with subsequent introductions from east and central haplotypes. This allowed increased gene flow within new Florida populations. Kolbe proceeded to show that there were at least 8 separate introductions of annals to Florida, which further increased diversity. By 1970, some northern populations exhibited a mean sequence divergence of 7.8%, which is 4.5 times greater than native Cuban populations. Through this research, Kolbe found that invasive species counter the evolutionary bottleneck through multiple introductions over time. His later research supports this by showing that the admixture of genetic material from distinct native populations allows the increased within-species diversity of introduced populations. These findings allow advances in biological control research, as the increased genetic diversity of invasive species must be considered. By limiting further introductions to an invasive population in the lag phase, conservation biologists can inhibit evolution of these species and reduce damages. Additionally, the use of biological mechanisms such as pathogens, parasites, and predators can reduce the gene flow of the target species and prevent adaptive evolution. Kolbe's research triggered a cascade of findings in invasion biology beyond the realm of lizards. The concept of multiple introductions has since been applied to explain how species such as bees, beetles, and even invasive Galapagos tomatoes have succeeded in new environments. While there is still much to be put in place to prevent damages caused by invasive species, Kolbe's work shows us the genetic basis of how invasive species survive and evolve in new environments. And it all started with the work of Jason Kolbe and some Cuban lizards.